So please stay away from this kind of stuff, 100%. That's more of the problem. Hey guys, welcome to the studio today. Let's be honest, I completely screwed up. As you know, I daily vlog for now almost 3 years. I haven't missed a single day. Today was so close to miss it because we had so much stuff to take care of today. A lot of DJ courses, a lot of music production courses, which I really need to find a solution for that. I can't do that because my main focus is making my own music and advancing as a DJ and producer. I also had to take care of a lot of emails, phone calls, planning the dance fair, planning the remix contest. There's a bunch of interesting stuff coming up really soon, which leaves me today with the sun. It's already gone. I haven't started vlogging, have no real topic. But I got a list on my computer, like emergency vlog ideas. One of them, and it's like the oldest that is on this list, is actually talking about drugs. I've tried to stay away from picking that as a topic, and I think today is a perfect day to talk about it. My personal experience in the EDM scene with drugs, because a lot of people have misconceptions. Some people think it's way more than it actually is. Some think it's way less than it actually is. So today, some real talk, basically. So as you might know, I'm already DJing for 15 years. And in the first 3-4 years, it was only hip hop music. With the hip hop guys, it's usually weed, booze, cigarettes, and that's then really it. Like no other drugs usually. What I disliked and I think is way more dangerous than the hip-hop scene, at least here in Germany, is the fighting. Like hip-hop clubs, if someone does something that someone else doesn't really like, there's a fight. And sometimes these fights end with knives or even bullets. So hip-hop parties, I have to say, are actually the most dangerous, especially for girls. They get grabbed at places where a guy shouldn't grab a lady that is a gentleman, especially a random girl he doesn't know. This happens a lot in places like this, and this also leads to the fighting, stabbing, and the bullets. So hip-hop parties, as much as I love the music, I avoid them, at least here in Germany. And then we got the techno scene, the EDM scene, the rave scene, the dance scene, like all of the electronic kinds of music, ranging from the more like posh kind of, let's say, vocal house, more kind of Miami, fancy, rich kind of stuff, to the very, very underground Berlin, deep in the cellar, techno kind of stuff. And there, it's definitely more drugs, but way, way, way less fighting, like almost none. I've actually never been to a house party where anyone, no, like, also the vibe is a lot nicer between the guests. Yes, some of them are like heavily on drugs, but they're at least friendly. And as long as everyone is doing whatever they want without like harming someone else, I'm totally fine with that. For the more fancy parties, it's usually cocaine, like the rich VIP guys. Then for the more EDM big room, it's more ecstasy. And then in the techno scene, it's ecstasy and pep, like the cheap kind of cocaine makes you just stay awake forever and ever, ever, ever. And a lot of people always ask me how much drugs are people consuming. I don't really know, and there is no statistic about it. But I have to say, in my 15 years of DJing, I've never ever been to a party, to a club, to a festival where I didn't see anyone taking any drugs. There was always someone. And there will be always someone. People like to try things out. They're at a festival, so they should do what they want to do, as long, again, as they don't harm themselves too much or start harming other people. I'm personally not really pro legalizing drugs, but if someone wants to try it out and doesn't get stuck taking it every single day at the end and just screwing up their entire life, I'm totally fine with that. People are curious. People want to know what it feels like. And that's okay, as long as it's not like the really, really hard, super addicting kind of stuff that makes you instantly go crazy. And also the kind of things like mushrooms, like everything that makes you lose control is maybe also a little bit dangerous. I know people that had like really weird trips and were never the same again. So be careful. But yeah, again, to the usage and the amount, It's really everywhere. I don't want to lie and tell you anything else. If you go to any festival, you go backstage, you go and try to find something, you will find someone that has something. So it's definitely there. Is it a big problem? Yes, probably it's a problem, because as you might know, for example, the Electric Zoo Festival was shut down because I think like 5, 6, 7 people died, all because of drug overusage, and all of them were first-time users. And I think there is like the problem. People need to be educated more, and it shouldn't be like something that is forbidden, but something that if you want to try it, do it in a controlled environment. Maybe with friends that are experienced, maybe start with a little and not at a huge festival surrounded by thousands and thousands of people that are strangers with a substance you don't even know how it acts, how much you should take, where it comes from, what's in it. So please stay away from this kind of stuff, 100%. That's more of the problem. The drug usage itself, maybe not that much. Not trying to say like drugs are positive, but also necessarily not negative. I think everyone should do their own experience if they want to. If they don't, that's also totally fine. I will probably get a lot of hate in the comments for saying that, but again, I'm really for everyone should do whatever they feel like doing. If someone wants to take a certain substance and try it out of curiosity, he will do it no matter what. There is no way to stop him from that. Then it's better to educate and do it in a controlled environment. So anyways, I will end the vlog right here. Let's continue the discussion in the comments. What is your experience with drugs, seeing other people, your own personal, if you want to share that, and also your opinion about what should change, if it should stay as it is. Is it a problem, or is it just a part of it? Is it just EDM? Is it also other music, other kind of styles? So anyways, we'll see us tomorrow back again. A promise, full on vlog here in the studio, me DJing, making music as you're used to. Today just the exception. And yeah, see you tomorrow back again. Sign out.